Yes.
Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to be here in Potsdam. 17 years, my first time here, and I'm from Brazil, and I apologize for the presentation is not perfect. I have lost my luggage. I'm from Brazil, and my luggage was lost during 2 days. And some hours ago, I received it with the components for the demonstration, okay? With the material for the demonstration. And so it was a little bit rushed, the presentation. And at least I'm here. I lost the problem in the morning, in the afternoon before, but I've arrived here, at least. I'm talking to you about the scientific micropipe for microcontrollers in the IoT. Why scientific micropipe? I'm a physicist, but I work a lot with computational physics, and I try to use IoT, microcontrollers, programming, using the formalization that is needed for sensor data. Okay, so I will put a critical view about the many sensors that IoT are making available for billions of people, but this data of the sensors should be analyzed in terms of error, precision, how many digits, etc. Okay. MicroPython is a free and open source implementation of Python 3. It's not 100% compatible. It's something like 98% compatible, because it was meant to work with for example, 10 kbytes of RAM. Okay, it's a Python 3, but very optimized. It was created by Damien George. It's a physicist also, too, coincidence. And it was created 3-4 years ago. And he created the board, the Pi board, the first board, the language, okay? And there is a community around him. So the site of MicroPython, there is a test drive. Sometimes it is online. Really, and there are documentation, etc. There are downloads. There is download here for the images, the firmware. For example, for many boards, PyBird 1, PyBird Lite, Wi-Fi, that I'm showing here. And MicroPython, until 2015, had only two boards, two hardware boards, PyBird and Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi with Wi-Fi, okay? But in the beginning of the last year, you had some releases like MicroPython ported for ESP8266, BBC microbit for more than 1 million children from United Kingdom. It was given for children of 11 to 12 years old, and you can also buy BBC microbit. Wi-Fi 2 with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Lo-Fi, it was the first microcontroller with Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and LoRa, and it was natively MicroPi. And the other boards, SciPi with Sigfox, OpenEV, it's T1's MicroPython and has a camera, a little camera, optimized to machine vision. All these boards run MicroPython. These two don't run MicroPython natively. You have to install MicroPython. So, here, for example, my board, the first board, this version is a new one, but the first one was almost the same. Wi-Fi, the second board, Wi-Fi first. The MicroPi project for ESP8266 last year. BBC MicroBit. And you can. Yes, there is Python here. And you can develop without installing any software. You can use the browser to develop. It's very important for children and parents to have a simple tool to develop. Wi-Fi 2, okay. Low-Fi, and OpenEV, a new version, it will be released, I think, next month, and the older version. So it has a very small board, microcontroller with a camera, using MicroPi. Okay? And the, sorry, I don't think we have time in the rush. The free memory of these boards, is between 8 KB, BBC MicroBit, only 8 KB, to almost 100 KB of fiber. Okay? So to develop for MicroPython is different from developing to Python, because you have your memory constraint, very important. Well, about the demonstration. First, I show almost the last one. This microcontroller, this board is low-fi with LoRa. Okay, so you can have some kilometers of the communication kilobits per second, approximately, until distance. Some kilometers, depending on the region. BBC MicroBit here. It's excellent price, and it's been used for 1 million children. And this year, there will be a MicroBit for an international version, released in other countries. So MicroBit is now an organization, not only British. Okay. And well, simple to remember when you are alone, not in front of a lot of people. Okay, and I will use this. For example, it's very simple to use. I recommend to use MicroPython in the interpretable mode, interactive mode. You can also make scripts, of course. And so I use a terminal using USB serial connection, okay, to enter in MicroPython on the first board. It's a new version of the first board, PyBoard. Okay? So this command, it's runs MicroPython almost the last version. Okay, there is a new version in January. And it's not the compiled language. Yes, it's Python. Okay. It's like a microcomputer, in reality a microcontroller, running Python almost as an operating system. So it's the dream of Python users. Only Python. It's not Linux, not macOS, not Windows. Only Python. Almost full Python. Okay? And, well, some modules are already loaded. For example, the PyBoard module has a lot of submodules. And, for example, information, detailed information of this board, microcontroller. You have here about kbytes, and flash memory is something about 90 kbytes. There are some files there, so it show less. And yes, you have the release, the version of the PyBoard, and it's very simple to read. I'll show a sensor connected to the ADC analogical to digital converter of this board. This board has some inputs with 12 bits of the analogical to digital converter. And to read the ADC port, it's very simple. It's one line of code. Okay? Yes, I read the board. It is oscillating because I have a infrared range finder of the sharp here. It can measure the distance between 10 to 150 centimeters. So, I will run a script to, okay? And this, what I'd like to show that if the data is stable, the physical quantity is stable, the reading is not stable. You have a lot of noise. All the sensors have noise. All the physical quantities, I'm a physicist, all the measured physical quantities in the world have errors, uncertainties. And the IoT community is forgetting this important thing. When we are publishing sensor data, it's important to take into account this reality, okay? So the quantity here is not stable, the distance, okay? And I run another script show the statistics of these readings. Okay? So the distance of my hand was 16 centimeters, 17 centimeters, with a standard deviation. Without statistical treatment, it was a huge, more than 1 centimeter, the standard deviation. With a statistical treatment, removing some peaks, some data not good, it was reduced. And now I will show. When I increase the distance, when I increase the distance, the error is increased. For example, and I have to increase it more. So the error is increased with the distance. It's not constant. Here we import another script with uncertainty calculation. So I have imported a module. I have created the adapted a module from Python to MicroPython, calculating uncertainties, errors, error propagation. Here I have to put the hand on the obstacle here. So we have 70 centimeters, which are of 1 centimeter. But if the distance is increased, the error is increased. Okay? And this is done by error propagation, uncertainty propagation. It's a code, very simple. Scripts. So this code is a class. And it's possible to run in machines with in MicroPython boards with free memory, small free memory. There's no problem. And this code was not available before. Here I will present another board. Here I have a ESP8266 microcontroller configured with MicroPython, and the serial port is a little bit different. And there is a lot of sensor connected here. It's a BME280 sensor with pressure, humidity, and temperature. All of them, they have uncertainty errors. So I will show a statistics. Oh, before. Just to show that this microcontroller has about where is the library? Sorry. It has 28 gigabytes of RAM only. Okay? I will show the reading of the sensor. Working. So we have the pressure reading, it has a lot of noise, and I run the same sensor with other configuration, because this sensor has many modes of reading, and in this new configuration the error is a lot smaller. So it's very important to understand the sensors. The PDF of this sensor has about 50 pages. It takes a little time, yes? So the uncertainty is just 4 instead of a very huge one before. And it's a web server running on this MicroPython board, and it shows the 3 quantities, physical quantities, with errors. And you have here, you can see that the errors, for example, the window before had 2 parameters, measurement parameters that you can configure the error estimation of the sensor. And the majority of people exposes the data sensor without showing the error. There is the error. It's very important. And the scientific model is available for MicroPython. The math model is available, and not exactly the same for all boards. For example, Bips Microlithy is very limited. You have for PyBird, a fast Fourier transform in assembler code, available from MicroPython. It's very fast, okay? And you can compare with a supercomputer, Grade 1, some years ago, with a PyBird that's here. Okay, it's comparable to a Grade 1, calculating fast Fourier transform using MicroPython, okay? And I participate in this project, Tweetball, where you use there's an IoT experiment where all the sensors will have control of errors and uncertainties. Okay? So you have the responsibility to show for the community about 10 sensors, all of them controlling the details of the measurements. Okay? And the, all the development using microcontrollers and Raspberry Pi is done with Python MicroPy. Okay? Thank you very much. Thank you very much.